Hey, just a really quick look at some Transformers. I'm not going to get into too much detail on them, but just to see, these three are pretty damn cool. We've got Soundwave, Shockwave, and Ravage to have a quick look at as well. All of these, well, two of them certainly, in fact, all three really are kind of showing the kind of Bumblebee movie artwork, which again, if you haven't seen that first couple of opening minutes of the Bumblebee movie, go watch that, then come back, it'll make more sense. But for most Transformers fan, you will know that scene intimately. And what these are really showing is Hasbro finally kind of catching up to share some of these kind of figures from that opening sequence of the movie, which is just phenomenal. It's really good. The thing I love about that sequence of the movie is the Transformers really just look like great robots rather than vehicles. I'm not really fussed about what they transform into, but just really cool. So anyway, real quick stuff, let's go through. So look, Ravage is there. We'll look get a look at him in just a second. You can see obviously he is in his doggy mode with lots of weapons and missiles there, and he transforms into one heck of a fat cassette into Soundwave's chest. We'll show that quickly, but really nice box, great artwork, and just fab to see the kind of close up, that CGI of him there, this wolfy, whatever he's supposed to be, I don't know, but pretty damn cool. Core class, tiny little figure. So again, there's loads and lots of steps. We'd be here all day. If you want to check some of this stuff out in much more depth and detail, go to my buddy Chefatron. He reviews lots and lots of Transformers and goes into just inane detail, crazy stuff, and goes through them all and transforms everything. And he's your man if you want to get into all that stuff. But mine basically sit here as robots. They do know what transform, but that's what comes in with those. We've got the mini Shockwave as well, that Core Class 2. Again, using the kind of artwork from that Bumblebee movie, or taking the kind of CGI shot from it. I mean, it's literally blink and you miss it. He's in the background. It's really hard to get to see him. That's what he transforms into, as a kind of tank thing, I guess, if you want. So again, I just think he looks great in his robot mode. 13 steps to transform him. Not much else to show you on the packaging. In terms of instructions for him, again, just really simple stuff. Few steps, fold arms, fold legs, whoop, straight into tank mode thing, prowler attack, whatever. It's kind of for that Floatship, great, but ultimately, I want him as a robot. He looks fab, and here he is. Here is how he looks. And Shockwave is just looking very cool indeed. Let me just zoom right in. We'll get a quick look at him. Some nice paint on this little guy here too, a little bit of silver accentuations here and there, that kind of wine color and red. Again, for a tiny core class figure, we're talking this figure here's a Star Wars Black Series figure. I'll review in just a second. So we're probably talking about kind of 4 inches tall, really not that big at all. But packing in the articulation, got his weapon there too. You can see that's removable. You can pop it out his hand if you want, but it's got a little bit of a. It adds a little bit of articulation having that on the hand there too, but it just looks badass. Really good for a tiny little core class figure. I love it. I love this range. It's a really nice kind of like mini display range of Transformers, and they're really beginning to kind of churn out some of the best ones. Obviously, we've had a mini Soundwave recently, kind of classic G1 style-y, but this guy looks pretty good for a small core class. There's a lot of detail packed in him. Different kinds of plastic. The purple looks great. Solid. Absolutely solid little figure. And again, really pretty good on the articulation side. There's all sorts of movement for such a small figure. All sorts of rotational points as well. So, tiny little figure, budget price. Go grab one. Dorkside Toys has a lot of this stuff up on pre-order. This Soundwave, I've actually got one. I've got another one on pre-order with them. But I did get the Ravage from them, which we'll take a look at in just a second. Soundwave as well. Just again, just loved him from this sequence in the movie. Absolutely fantastic. Comes with both his shoulder cannon and his side weapon too. And again, I think Chefatron has already reviewed all of this in detail, going through every single step and how easy and how good it is to transform. And it's into this kind of rather odd-looking kind of macro binocular-like device thing. But we'd be here all day going through the 26, 27, was it 28 steps to build that? Okay, whatever. Ravage, obviously, fold them down, and there's instructions there for him. To pop him into the chest. Now, we don't get a button on Soundwave's chest that pops open to pop, you know, basically. Or, well, there is a button on his chest, I should say, but you cannot get Sinewave to pop his chest. He doesn't have the kind of articulation to pop it, but we'll get into him in just a sec. Quick look at the packaging, and again, look at that artwork. Oh my god, that CGI shot there. So there is a lot of fading, weathering, damage, detail. It's really not here in this Transformers figure by Hasbro, but look, we got the mold, we got the sculpt, a little bit of paint, weathering detail. You can apply your own chrome pen, a bit of decay here and there, but it looks very nice. There's a lot of line marking you can do on this too, so it's a very clean figure. Nice, mostly solid cardboard figure with a little bit of the CGI display in the background. 83 in the Studio Series. Again, looking super mean. I love it. And you've got a display inside, which you've seen probably on just about every Studio Series figure recently. And again, there is in colour the kind of macro binoculars type thing that he becomes. It just does nothing for me. But he looks so good in that mode. 29 steps to transform. Yep, you can do that one on your own. There's the UPC should you need it, but it's just beginning to come into stock at stores in the kind of Asian market. A buddy of mine managed to pick his up and let me have a little review of this one. But as I say, I've got one on at Dorkside Toys, so check out them, link in the description below. You can, as I said, pop the chest open and inside is Ravage. Now he's really, really tight to kind of pack inside. It's really kind of hard to get him out, but you can do it. And if you pop open the back of Soundwave, you can kind of pop him out a little, and you kind of need to really. And that's how he is really on the figure. But nice little touch there. You can see the kind of cab piece folds inside, and you get that kind of nice looking part with the cassette. But there you go. So a little bit more detail. So that is Ravage all tucked up inside. Looking very cool. A quick unpose of him is. Let's quickly get a look at that mouth. How cool is that? Let's zoom in here just a little. He's very, very nifty indeed. And he comes with lots of different missiles and parts and pieces you can attach to him, onto side little missiles onto his legs, etc. So yeah, he has a lot of packing him in to get in there, but again, he's a little bit fat for a cassette. I mean, that's pretty chunky, but still a cool little figure nonetheless. And he tucks in pretty reasonably inside Soundwave's chest. So, get a look at this figure here. We get some nice detail on the figure, the silver around the mouth there. Again, lots, it's very solid blue as you can see, and just really not representative of that kind of more purplish, weathered tone there. But do you know what? Again, they've given us the mold. I'm not going to complain. I never even thought we would get one in this mold from the movie, but we have, and I'm very, very grateful. I will be going over this when I get mine with a line marker and really kind of detailing, chroming this up if I ever get time. But it's a particularly good looking figure, I think. Just desperate to be weathered. That is the main issue I see, but I absolutely love this. Real War Machine vibes with a shoulder cannon going on there. Just really, really cool. Loving it. One of my favorite Transformers. It's what really kind of got me into, or made me really like Transformers, and then years later, just finally think, screw it, I'm going to collect some. And here I was. So it's a solid enough build, pretty chunky, and certainly in terms of his legs, you get some great poses out of this guy here. As you can see, they all tuck in pretty neatly into the figure. And loads of articulation and movement. There's quite a range that you can go on there. Lift up the flap, always about the flaps. You get lots of different kind of poses, as I said, with the with moving some of these elements there. So you can really put them in whatever kind of pose you want. It's not too bad at all. And we've got rotational ankles here as well, which just give you that extra pose on them, pivoting around there too. So pretty much a standardly good transformer, with lots of movement and options to pose them. What's not to like, really? Colors are a little bit off on that weapon, I have to say. It's more kind of brown, kind of weird chocolate color, to be honest. And I don't, again, think that was really the color that was in the movie. But there we go. Again, a little bit of weathering and touch-up, I think, would make a world of difference to this figure. But a little bit of chrome silver inside, which I really do love inside the arms. It adds a little bit of a difference. Understandably, from a paint point of view, they've kept it a little light in what they've added. But looking at the silvers, the blues, the dark grays, the real silver inside, the chocolatey weapon, they've placed the silver in the right areas and kept it minimal. It's not done too badly at all. We've got some nice small red highlights and touches, but ultimately, if there was any gripes, it's about paint. It's just not getting a chance to get that really weathered and looking great. But as it stands, I think the sculpt on this is fantastic. And the fact that, yet again, you can get Ravage to tuck up inside, I think it's excellent. I think it's a really good Transformer. Again, all of these I think are up on Dorkside. I think the Shockwave Meta sold out, but check it up there. Link in the description below. And if not, if they've sold out, we'll put a link to eBay or something underneath. But you gotta get this guy, absolutely solid. And I think he should be hitting some retail stores pretty much soon enough around the globe as we speak. Anyway, let us know what you think of this, and we'll see you for some more quick Transformers coming up in the future. Cheers.